वेलकम टू 10th स्टैंडर्ड CBSE मैथ्स क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशंस वी आर डिस्कसिंग द क्वेश्चंस आस्क्ड इन अर्लियर इयर्स इन द बोर्ड ऑलरेडी वी हैव सीन 20 सम्स नाउ दिस इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू वॉच अनदर 5 सम्स सो आई एम राइटिंग ऑल दिस 5 सम्स व्हिच आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टुडे इन दिस वीडियो So that afterwards you can do your self revision. You can just see the problems and you can stop the video, work out, and you can check up whether you are right. So that's why I have not written that one problem and then solved and then another problem solved. I have given that these are the 5 problems we are going to discuss. You can watch it, but afterwards you can take it as a self test. Now, I got to the question number 21. However, before that, let me thank you those who have subscribed. Also shared with your friends. And in case you are not subscribed, I hope you will subscribe after watching this video and find the maths is very interesting. So what I do is here 2x plus 9 I am writing it as equal to 13 minus x. X I am taking to the other side. To remove the square root I am squaring up. So this becomes 2x plus 9 and this becomes 13 minus x the whole square which becomes 169 minus 26x plus x square. 13s are 169. Minus 13 into 2ab, sorry, is 2 into 13 into minus x and then minus x into minus x. So here 2x plus 9. Since x square term is there, I am taking everything there, therefore it becomes x square and minus 26x and this 2x also becomes minus 2x and then 169, the 9 goes here, so minus 9. The result is that x square minus 28x. Plus 160 equal to 0. Product is 160. Sum is 28. Very simple one. 28s are 160. 20 plus 8 is 28. Therefore, this I can say is equal to x minus 20 and x minus 8 equal to 0. Which means that x equal to 20 or x equal to 8. Here solve the problem. X equal to 20 and x equal to 8. Put it in the problem and check whether both the values are satisfy the equation. When you are putting x equal to 20, 20 into 2, 40, 49, 49 square root of that. And this is 20 equal to 13. If you take root of 49 as, you can take it as plus or minus 7. If you take it as minus 7, this satisfies. Otherwise, it will not. If you are taking x equal to 8, this becomes 25 square root of that, e plus 8, that is equal to 13. Square root of 25, positive number, if you take it as 5, and 5 plus 8, 13. So, the values of x are given. Now, I go to the 22nd problem. Question number 22. Here is nothing, 4 by x minus 3. So, I have put 1 for the clear understanding. Taking LCM x, so this part will be only 4 and but this will be 3x. And this is 5 by 2x plus 3. Now, cross multiply 4 minus 3x, 2x plus 3 equal to 5x. Now multiplying that 4 into 2, so 8x, 4 into 3, 12, minus 3 into 2, minus 6x square, minus 3 into this, minus 9x equal to 5x. 4 2s are 8x, 4 into 3, 12, this is minus, so minus 3 into 2, so minus 6x square, minus 3 into 3, therefore minus 9x. Now this part on simplification 8x and minus 9x, so minus 6x square and minus x plus 12, that is equal to 5x. minus 6x square, and then 8 and minus 9, that becomes minus 9, bigger number sign. Then plus 12 equal to 5x. Taking everything to that side to make x square term positive, x square, 6x square, minus x goes there. So 6x, 12 goes, so minus 12 equal to 0. Divide everything by 6, you will be getting x square plus x minus 2, 0, which is very simple, x plus 2 and x minus 1 equal to 0. So x equal to therefore 1 or minus 2. Yes, very simple problem. Now you go for one. I am going to question number 23, which is on the board now. 2x by something plus 1 by something plus 3x plus 9 by something. Some three terms are there. So fortunately, LCM will be only two terms, x minus 3 and 2x plus 3. That is a repetition. Generally, students do, the first they do for simplification of this process, taking LCM, and then go to this. But you can take it, the LCM for the entire problem. Now, 2x by x minus 3, x minus 3 is here. So what you have to take? 2x into 2x plus 3. 2x plus 3 is there, therefore I have to take x minus 3. Both the terms are here. Simply you write 3x plus 9, that is equal to 0. Since the other side is 0, when you are taking everything there, 0 into everything, 0 to anything is 0, therefore this becomes 0. The denominator goes off. So multiplying the numerator, so this part is 4x square, 6x, removing the bracket, x minus 3 and 3x plus 9 equal to 0. Simplifying this process, 4x square, 6x plus x, 7x, 7x plus 3, 10x, 9 minus 3 plus 6 equal to 0. You can divide it by 2, therefore I am writing 2x square plus 5x plus 3 equal to 0. So very simple thing, product is 6 and the sum is 3, therefore 2 3s are. So this is 2x square plus 2x plus 3x plus 3. These two, 2x I am taking. So left out x plus 1, I am here taking 3, so which is equivalent to x plus 1, 0. Therefore, 2x plus 3 into x plus 1 is equal to 0, which means x plus 1, 0, x equal to minus 1. Or I can say that 2x plus 3 can be 0, 2x equal to minus 3 and x is equal to minus 3 by 2. So that completes the problem. Question number 24, x plus 1 by this plus x minus 2 by this equal to 4 minus out 2x plus 3 by x minus 2. Those who are watching regularly, have seen in one video I have told a kutty story, small story. And for those who have not listened, let me repeat it very quickly. Very long ago, in a village there was a man. The innocent villagers considered him as a great saint who can do wonders. But a young man was having a doubt about the genuinity of the saint. He wanted to check whether he is really a saint or a fraud. So one day he went to his place with his folded hand. He told Swamiji, "I have a butterfly in my folded hand." And the villagers are praising that you know everything. Now, can you tell me whether the butterfly in my folded hand is alive or dead? Is it alive or dead? That's the question. Now, can you answer me? That was the story I told and asked you to think it over. And what the sage would have replied, or what the sage had replied, is a suspense. I kept it as a suspense. So those who have not watched, please think it over. Now let me go back to the sum, because doing the sum may be monotonous. So that's why I have given this story. So you can just think, and then we can come back to the problem. I will tell that in the coming videos. Now let me go for this. Taking LCM part, so x minus 1 and this is x plus 2. Here we have x plus 1. Since x minus 1 is there, I take x plus 2. And x minus 2 divided by x plus 2, therefore I am taking x minus 1. On the other side, 4 divided by 1 for the convenience. So LCM is now x minus 2. So this part will be 4 into x minus 2. Minus of 2x plus 3. X plus 1, x minus 2, and this one. Now let me go for expansion. This part will be x square, x and 2x, so 3x, and plus 2. And this part will be x square, minus 2x, minus x, therefore minus 3x, minus 2 into 1 plus 2. The whole thing divided by x minus 1 into x plus 2, which means that x square plus x minus 2. Here we are multiplying that 4x minus 8 minus 2x minus 3 divided by x minus 2. So x square and x square, this becomes 2x square. 3x and minus 3x goes off, 2 plus 2, 4. Divide by this equal to 4x minus 2x, so 2x minus 8 minus 3, so minus 11, and cross multiply that you will be getting x minus 2 here, and here you will be getting this part x square plus x minus 2. Now expand it, 2x square into x, 2x cube, 2x square into minus 2, 4 into x, 4 into minus 2, 2x into x square, and 2x into x, 2x into minus 2, then minus 11 into x square, minus 11 into x, minus 11 into minus 2. So 4x minus 2x, 2x minus 8 minus 3 minus 11, and then this part goes there, x square plus x minus 2, and this part x square plus x square, 2x square, 3x get cancelled, 2 plus 2, 4, and this comes over here, x minus 2. I have expanded 2x square into x, 2x cube, and this is minus 4x square, this is 4x, and this is minus 8. Here 2x cube and then 2x square plus 2 into this minus 4x minus 11x square minus 11x plus 22. Now I go to the top, I rub it off all these things. When you take it to the other side, the x cube term get cancelled. Here is 2x square, but this 4x square goes there. I'm sorry, let me simplify this part. So there are a lot of terms, minus 4x square plus 4x minus 8 is equivalent to, here is on 2x square and this is minus 11x square, so minus 9x square, and then comes x, so that is minus 4x and then constant term plus 22. Minus 4x square plus 4x minus 8, this side is simple, here you have 2x square and then minus 11x square, so minus 9x square. and minus 4 and minus 11. So minus 15x and then plus 22. Taking everything to that side, 9x square. I'm sorry, to this side. So this becomes 9x square plus 15x and plus 22 equal to 0. And already here minus 4x square plus 4x and minus 8 and this. So this one simplification, you get 5x square, 15 plus 4, so 19x, 22 minus 8, so plus 14. So the problem was a little bit lengthy. The factorization is very simple because 14 into 5, 19, 14 plus 5, 19. Therefore, this one, 19x can be written as plus 5x plus 14x plus 14 equal to 0. Taking 5x, you get x plus 1 and 14, x plus 1. So, x plus 1 into 5x plus 14 equal to 0. That means that x plus 1 equal to 0 or x equal to minus 1. 5x plus 14 equal to 0 or 5x equal to minus 14. And x equal to minus 14 by 5. So we have solved the problem. Now I go for the last problem for the day. The last problem. Root of x plus 1 plus root of 2x plus 5 equal to 3. What you do is keep one root on one side and the other one you take it here to the other side, square up. This will become x plus 1. This is your a and this is your b, so a minus b square, so a square minus 2ab, so minus 2 into 3 into this part plus b square, simply 2x minus 5 equal to 0. So you take this 3a and you take this b, a minus b, a minus b, a, you are going to square up, so a square is 3 into 3, 9, 2 times of this, 2 into 3 into 2x, root of 2x plus 5, root of 2x minus 5 on squaring, you'll get 2x minus 5. This part you simplify, this becomes minus 6 times of this and plus 2x minus 5. Now this part you rewrite, this is 2x, 9 minus 5 plus 4 and minus 6 times of this. On this side you have x plus 1. Take this one this side, so it becomes 6 times of 2x minus 5. Here you have 2x plus 4 and minus x and minus 1. 2x minus x, therefore x, 4 minus 1, 3. Now again you square up because you have the square root. So this is 36. Becomes 2x minus 5 and that on squaring, x square plus 6x and plus 9. The result is now this is x square plus 6x plus 9. 36 2s are 72, 36 into 5, that is 180. Now I'll go to the upper part of the board and I'm rubbing it off. So that you can watch very clearly. So this is x square, 72 x comes, therefore minus 66 x, 180 comes there, so it is 180 plus 9, 189. 63 into 3 is 189, the 66 also comes there on addition, therefore this part is x square. Sorry, I can write the answer straight away, x minus 63 and x minus 3 equal to 0. So, x minus 3 equal to 0, that means x equal to 3. X minus 63 is 0, therefore x equal to 63. These are the two answers, possible answer. You just substitute there and check whether you are getting 3. So that completes the problems. So before I say goodbye, let me tell you what the sage had replied. The story was very simple. The young man asked, keeping the butterfly in his folded hand, asked the sage whether the butterfly was alive or dead. The sage calmly replied that it lies in your hand. That means that if you want to tightly closed, it may die, or you may allow it to live. So it is in your hand. Now you may be surprised why I told you the story and built up the suspense. The reason is that as the life of the butterfly was in his hand, getting symptom is in your hand. If you work hard, who can prevent you from getting sent up? So work hard, understand the concept, practice well, and achieve sent up. As usual, if the video is interesting, if you are not subscribed, subscribe it. If you have subscribed already, thank you. And pass the information to your friends or relatives, relations, neighbors. Let them also gain knowledge and get sent up. All the best to you. We'll see in the next class. Thank you for watching.